have no basis to burn anybody's work, but people have basis to burn our work. So when you're talking about anthropologists, we are not the ones. We are rather, and if there's a year of 55 students, and all of them want to use oil paint, we will allow them. We don't tell students what to choose. This is their own choice. We just guide. All we have done is to say that, oh, we are not going to say, all of you do this. We haven't said that. And I'm surprised we are not seeing paintings there. We need to have our eyes set on a particular type of painting. Because that thing wrote there are like 30 canvases stuck together into a chaos form or something. But actually, there were paintings on canvas. So I don't get it. When the impression is that nobody is practicing painting, look at this. All we do. We don't tell students what to do. But hitherto, there is a set, you know, what everybody knows. What we are condemning is the hegemony of one practice. That's all. That's all we are condemning. We are not condemning any format. We don't care whether it's oil or water. But I think it has brought in film, photography, painting, whatever, as well. Viable forms of practice. Collage. I think his work will be like a big collage. If you are doing collage on a small scale and someone does it on a big scale,
I think my
for me, as someone who's interested in history, I also become very problematic to me and polemic. What is tradition? Where do you start tradition from? As Africans, when we say tradition, if we started with the colonial period, then our tradition would be on canvas. When we went beyond the traditional period, the colonial period, it gave us Wings, it gave us Zaria, it gave us Nsukka. So at what point did we start tradition? And when we look at tradition, installation is not a Western form of art. It's within our system. Our way of performance is within our system. So artists then are made to say, this whole history of art, right from the inception of humanity and how we want to emancipate the future of humanity is before you. And you can refer to any aspect of it to interpret contemporaneity, to do something with your present situation. So an artist can make reference to any aspect of history. And one of them asked, well, this is painting, but my lecturer says this is not painting when I was in school, because it's more on canvas.
Where the child to come back with certain ingredients. Your foundation ingredients, your ingredients. Your the child can draw, your the child can sculpt, the child can paint or whatever. Because really, in our school, about 10 years after school, was interviewed on BBC, and he said that a young artist gave him an invitation to visit the show. And he didn't like the young artist. Why? He said, you don't become an artist immediately after school. After 10 years after school, you have to learn all that you went to school to become an artist. That's what Tariq Ashok said. So, the rudiments help you to begin to learn what you learned.
I don't see a very sharp difference between Kumasi story and some of the art schools that were established at the same period. Remember, we are all coming from the colonial past. We are all coming from a situation where the curriculum was designed overseas. We are coming from a situation where the teachers came from overseas. And I hesitate to call it an imposition. But the teachers wanted to actualize the curriculum. And so basic things were taught. I feel that the way the curriculum was designed during the colonial period couldn't have been different. Because they had to bring exactly what they knew to come and teach on the continent. However, if we look through what happened in Zaria, I see a situation that exists now. From a recent listening to the Zarianists, those Ojokos call the rebels. The same thing you people are talking about now, several years after the Kumasi started, I imagine that was what the people, Uchokete and his friends, did did those days to exactly say, we are Africans, we are Nigerians, why are we not being allowed to look through our culture as a source of inspiration for the creation of our works? It's possible that the nature of art consumption in Ghana did not allow several of the classmates to produce and sell. Maybe galleries were not enough, maybe there were no auction houses like we have today, maybe there are no other platforms where people can get their work sold, you know. What is going on in a lot of the arts in town? A lot of people are struggling with it. It's not any different in engineering. We've heard people say installation is that, performance is that, but our reality is teach the basics, allow